Hello students, in previous class I was discussing about perceptrons. Hope the concept was clear. So what is perceptron? Actually perceptron is a type of ANN system, that is artificial neural network system, and perceptron takes a vector of real valued inputs, calculates a linear combination of these inputs, then it will output the result. If the output is 1, it indicates greater than some threshold, or if the result of perceptron is greater than some threshold, then it will output as 1, otherwise it will output as -1. So is it clear what is perceptron? Perceptron, it takes a vector of real valued inputs, then it calculates a linear combination of these inputs, then it will output. So output will be something like this. If the result is greater than some threshold, then perceptron it will output as 1, otherwise it will output as -1. So last class I discussed about this function and all, right? And also I discussed about this weights and bias, and what is the importance of weight and bias, means why these weights and bias are needed in perceptron function. And also I have illustrated one of the perceptron, right? So these are what the inputs, and this is what the constant. So these are what the weights we are applying. Perceptron will calculate a linear combination of these inputs, then it will produce the output. So this is how perceptron work. So this is also I discussed. That is an illustration of a perceptron based on the inputs and weights, also the bias. And here I have given the simple vector notation for the perceptron. Means perceptron can also be noted in terms of a vector notation like this. So in today's class I am going to discuss representational power of perceptrons. So we can view the perceptron as representing a hyperplane decision surface in the n dimensional space of instances. Instances are nothing but some points, right? So the perceptron output 1 for the instances lying on one side of the hyperplane, otherwise it will output as -1 for those instances lying on the other side. So this is also we can consider it as some illustration of perceptron. Here you can see two different cases here, right? So in this case we are viewing the perceptron as representing a hyperplane decision surface in n dimensional space. As you can clearly see here, n dimensional space of instances or n dimensional space of points. So in this case the perceptron output is 1 for the instances which are lying on one side of the hyperplane, and in other case the perceptron output is -1 for those instances which are lying on the other side. So this is also an representation or illustration of a perceptron, right? So the equation for this decision hyperplane is W vector dot x vector is equal to 0. Of course some sets of positive and negative examples can be separated by any hyperplane here. So those that can be separated are known as linearly separable sets of examples. It means that suppose some sets of positive and negative examples that cannot be separated by any hyperplane, but they can be separated by some perceptron. So such examples are known as linearly separable sets of examples. I hope this figure is clear. that is the decision surface represented by a two input perceptron. Here a setup training example sign, decision surface of perceptron, that will classify them correctly. And in the second case, a setup training examples that is not linearly separable, that is x1 and x2 are perceptron inputs. Positive examples are indicated by plus here, and negative examples are indicated by minus. So a single perceptron can be used to represent many Boolean functions. For example, if you assume Boolean values of 1 and minus 1, 1 means true, minus 1 means false. So if you assume the Boolean values of 1 and minus 1 or true and false, then one way to use a two input perceptron is to implement AND function, that is to set the weights W0 and W1, W2 and so on. So here consider we are setting a W0 as minus 0.8 and W1 and W2 as plus 0.5. So this perceptron can be made to represent the OR function instead by altering the threshold to W0, that is W0 equal to minus 3, right? In fact, AND OR can be viewed, that is AND OR can be viewed as special cases of M of N functions. That is, the functions where at least M of N inputs to the perceptron must be true. The OR function correspond to M equal to 1 and function to M equal to N. So it means that suppose consider AND OR. So these AND OR can be viewed as special cases of M of N functions. That is, the functions where at least M of N inputs to the perceptron must be true. Then the OR function correspond to M equal to 1 and function correspond to M equal to N. So any M of N function is easily represented using a perceptron by setting all the input weights to the same value, that is 0.5 consider, and then setting the threshold W0 accordingly. Here the perceptron can represent all of the primitive Boolean functions, that is AND, OR, NAND, NOR and all, right? So perceptron can represent these Boolean functions AND, OR, NAND, NOR and all, right? So unfortunately, however, some Boolean functions cannot be represented by a single perceptron, such as XOR function. So whose value is 1 if and only if x is not equal to y or x1 is not equal to x2. Means AND, OR, NAND, NOR can be represented by perceptron, but the XOR function cannot be represented by a single perceptron. So you can note that the set of linearly non-separable training examples, which are shown in the previous figure, that is this figure B, that is set up non-linearly, or the set of linearly non-separable training examples which are shown here in this figure B, so that will correspond to this XOR function. So this particular figure, it is corresponding to XOR function, which is the set of linearly non-separable training examples. Here the ability of perceptron to represent AND, OR, NAND, NOR is important because every Boolean function can be represented by some network of interconnected units based on these primitives. In fact, every Boolean function can be represented by some network of perceptron only two levels deep. This is important. That is, every Boolean function can be represented by some network of perceptron only two levels deep, means up to two levels deep. in which the inputs are fed to multiple units and the outputs of these units are then input to second final stage, because it is only up to 2 levels deep. So inputs are fed to multiple units and outputs of these units are input to second final stage, right? So one way is to represent the Boolean function in a disjunctive normal form. Here you can note that input to and perceptron can be negated by changing the sign of corresponding input weight. Because of the network of threshold units can represent a rich variety of functions, and because single units alone cannot, so we'll generally be interested in learning a multi-layer network of the threshold units. So that is what an interesting feature about the perceptron. So this is about the representational power of perceptrons. So next I will discuss the perceptron training rule, right? So even though we are interested in learning the networks of many interconnected units, so let us begin by understanding how to learn the weights for a single perceptron. Here, a precise learning problem is to determine a weight vector that causes the perceptron to produce the correct plus or minus one output for each of the given training examples. So several algorithms are known to solve this learning problem. Here we'll consider two of them, that is the perceptron rule and the delta rule. So these two algorithms are guaranteed to coverage to somewhat different acceptable hypothesis under somewhat different conditions. So they are important for the artificial neural networks because they provide a basis for learning networks of many units. Here, one way to learn an acceptable weight vector is to begin with random weights, then iteratively apply the perceptron to each training example, then modifying the perceptron weights whenever it misclassifies an example. So this process is repeated, iterating through the training examples as many times as needed until the perceptron classifies all the training examples correctly. Here, the weights are modified at each step according to the perceptron training rule, which revises the weight wi associated with input xi according to the rule, that is according to the perceptron training rule. And its representation is like this: wi is equal to wi plus delta wi, where delta wi is equal to some notation you can find, that is a n like notation, n of t minus o xi. Here t is the target output for the current training example, o is output generated by perceptron, then n is a positive constant called as a learning rate, this notation. So it is a positive constant, and this positive constant is known as learning rate. The role of the learning rate is to moderate the degree to which weights are changed at each step. So it is usually set to some small value, that is around 0.1, and it is sometimes made to decay as the number of weight tuning iterations that increases. Here there is a question like, why should this update rule coverage towards successful weight values? So to get an intuitive feel, consider some special cases. Suppose the training example is correctly classified already by perceptron. In this case, this t minus o is 0, making delta wi is 0, so that no weights are updated. Suppose the perceptron output as minus 1 when the target output is plus 1. So to make the perceptron output as a plus 1 instead of minus 1, in this case, the weights must be altered to increase the value of W vector dot X vector, that is W dot X. For example, if Xi is greater than 0, then increasing Wi will bring the perceptron closer to the correctly classifying this example. Here you can notice that the training rule will increase Wi in this case, because T minus O and N and Xi are all positive. For example, if Xi equal to 0.8, N equal to 0.1, T equal to 1 and O equal to minus 1, then the weight update will be delta Wi equal to, if you can substitute these values, then the value of delta Wi is 0.16. I'll repeat these values. Consider Xi as 0.8, N equal to 0.1, T equal to 1, G and O equal to minus 1. In that case, the weight update, so this indicate weight update, so weight update value is 0.16. On the other hand, if T equal to minus 1 and O equal to 1, then weights associated with a positive Xi will be decreased rather than increased. So this is one observation with respect to perceptron training rule. So this is about the today's discussion, and in the next class I am going to discuss gradient descent and the delta rule. Thank you.